Thank you for joining Pioneer. My name is Aaron Pence. I'm from the Norman Central Library. I appreciate you spending a few minutes with me today. Last time, we learned how to change backdrops. It's a great tool for making your story really shine. But you probably noticed that our sprites just stayed in the same spot when our backdrops changed. That really slows down the full effect of what a backdrop change can do. So today, I want to talk about how to fix that. We're going to make our sprites move.
You already know some about how to do this, because we did it when we made our word move in Lesson 1. And I want to be really clear with you. I'm just picking some motion effects I like. There are so many different ways to move your sprites. Don't feel like these are the only ones. But they work well for my little story, and they will let me show you a couple of ideas for how to make an effect happen. I think the first thing I want is to make sure my sprites start correctly. In Scratch, and in a lot of computer programs, the computer remembers where it was the last time it did something. I don't want my cat to start in totally random places every time. I'd like her to always be in the right spot. Well, remember, computers are specific. If I want something to be the same way every time, I'd better tell it exactly which way I want it. So first things first, I'm going to use a trick I like. I'm going to click the green flag and then immediately click the red stop sign. That starts my program, but then cancels it. In this case, what it really does is switch to our starting backdrop. Next, I want my cat to start on the stairs, and I'd like my basketball to start at the end of the hallway. Scratch has a cool feature built in. If we click and drag the cat and the basketball to just where we want them, like this, then Scratch will not only keep track of their coordinates, it will even put those coordinates into the go to XY block in the motion category for us. So now that I have my sprites where I want them, I'll click on my cat sprite in the bottom right, go to motion, find the go to XY block, and drag it into my cat script right under the when green flag clicked hat block. Then I'll do the same thing for the basketball. Click the basketball sprite in the bottom right, grab the go to XY block, and snap it in under the event hat block. Next, I think I want my cat to head down the stairs. I can use this glide to XY block for that. And I can even use the same feature. I just drag the cat to where I'd like her to end up, and the coordinates in the glide to block update for me. Now, I can drag that block over to the script. Let's put it under the wait 2 seconds block. Now, run it. Hey, looks cool, right? Now, real quick, did you notice that now my basketball is interrupting my cat again? That's because when we added that 1 second glide, we didn't account for that extra second in our basketball script. It's easy to fix though. Click on the basketball sprite in the bottom right and change that wait block to wait for 3 seconds instead of 2, because the 2 seconds the cat is talking and the 1 second the cat is gliding adds up to 3 seconds. Let's use those same blocks for a couple of cool effects in the second backdrop. I'd like both my sprites to change position in this second backdrop. I think I want my basketball to say yeet when it's in the tree. Isn't that when basketballs normally say yeet? So I will first get the coordinates I want by clicking and dragging the basketball up into the tree. Then I'll take the go to XY block and snap it into the script right above the say yeet for 2 seconds block. Lovely. Now, I want a cool effect here. I want my cat to start almost off the screen and then to head up the path. So we'll drag her down here as low on the picture as we can make her. It might take a few tries to get it just right. Then, once she's there, we can get a go to XY block with the right coordinates from the motion category and snap that in right under the switch backdrop to mountain block. Next, I want the cat to glide up in front of the cave while the basketball is yeeting. Drag the cat sprite where you want her to end, I think right about here. And then grab a glide 1 seconds to XY block from the left. snap it in at the bottom, and take a look. So far, so good. Whoa, but did you see the cat move? It seems a little fast to me. Does it seem fast to you? I'm going to change the amount of glide time to 2 seconds instead of 1. Click on the 1 in the glide 1 seconds block, change it to 2, and now run your program. Take a look. Hey, cool. With just a couple of simple blocks, we got our sprites to always start in the right spot, and we got them to move with the backdrops. Awesome.
Looks cool, right? You're well on your way to being a brilliant animator. Next time, we'll learn about sizing your sprites. Thanks a lot. See you soon.